प्रभु पिगलानी जी, गौतम जी और इस हाल में बैठे हुए एक्सपर्ट्स, कि मेरा प्रिविलेज है इस संगम में आने का। कल साहिबान गुप्ता जी ने जब अनुरोध किया उसके पहले ही मैंने कंसर्न दे रखा था। कुछ कारणों से बिहार के डिप्टी सीएम और कृषि मंत्री यहाँ नहीं आ सके और उन्होंने मुझे अनुरोध किया इनॉग्रल सेशन में यहाँ पर जाने के लिए। तो मुझे लगता है बिहार सरकार की पॉलिसी का एक क्रम है, इसे मुझे यहाँ आने में काफ़ी खुशी है। इस हाल में बैठे हुए बहुत सारे वाइस चांसलर हैं, एक्सपर्ट्स हैं, प्रोफेसर हैं। एट टू टाइम्स इन माई कैरियर आई बीन एसोसिएटेड विद एजुकेशन। वन मैन आई वॉज पार्ट ऑफ द यूनिवर्सिटी ग्रांट कमीशन, अदर टाइम मैन आई वॉज पार्ट ऑफ द एग्रीकल्चर रिसर्च एंड एजुकेशन। And majority of the people in their organization used to be PhD. And by qualification, I have attained not more degree than graduation, because the subject I chose to graduate was the electronics and communication. In this post-graduation, I could do the PhD and the master's in that. And therefore, I remained a graduate. But coincidentally, being part of the higher education, by default, many of the people in the meeting, the doctors have to stop them at many times. The agriculture production in Bihar, let me address my inaugural letter. Bihar is an agrarian state with about 20% of the state GSDP coming from agriculture, and nearly 90% of the state population is rural in nature. And about more than 70% population gets their employment from the agriculture. When the 2011 census was to come, I was part of the urban sector. In 98, by 2001 census, the Bihar was one of the least urbanized states. In fact, from bottom of it considered, only after the Himachal, the urbanization ratio was very low. And at that time, since I was part of the urban sector, we used to educate that India needs more urbanization. India in the year 2001 was only 31.8% urbanized population. And since majority of the government revenues from the urban, comes from the urban area, and major portion of GDP was coming from the urban area, then there was general advocacy of educating for urbanization. And urbanization was linked to the employment, coincidentally. Now the talk is otherwise. The major employment is in the rural areas, in the agriculture sector. Therefore, now as part of the agriculture sector, we advocate that more emphasis to be given on the agriculture and rural irrigation system. Agriculture has experienced several transformations since independence. Sometime back, Green Revolution. Because of Green Revolution, the production and productivity of the rice and wheat increased substantially. Food grain production was 50.82 million metric tons in the year 50-51, which has increased to 252.22 million metric tons in the year 2015-16. That 5 times of the total production has gone up. And thanks to the policymakers, the financial institutions, the agriculture scientists, and academicians, which has led to the first Green Revolution. And it has brought self-sufficiency in the agriculture area. In fact, the India could dare to go to the parliament to bring a law in the name of the Food Security Act, which probably would have been could not have been thought. In many of the countries in the world haven't regarded Food Security Act, and we could dare to go for Food Security Act because of the step taken by your policymakers, scientists, and because of the outcome of the first Green Revolution. Now, buffer stock data I was getting, total food grain production we have achieved, and there are 12.69 million metric ton rice and 23.79 million ton wheat in the stock of government and media as on 1st January 2016. So we have become food surplus. Traditionally, food requirement has been assessed as per the calorie requirement of population. Therefore, calorie requirement for rural and urban population were determined at 2400 and 2100 calories respectively in the rural, urban and rural area. Beyond this, human beings need more than calorific alimentary food. And according to National Institute of the Nutrition, the balanced diet for an adult man with moderate activity should consist of 450 gram cereals, 90 gram pulses, 300 milliliter of milk, milk product, 200 gram roots and fibers, 100 gram green leafy vegetables, 200 gram other vegetables, 100 gram fruit, 30 gram sugar and 30 gram fat. And that's the topic what we are going to discuss today. Therefore, it is imperative that the diversification of Indian diet should now be emphasized after achieving self-sufficiency in food grain production. We have prepared an agriculture roadmap, and this is agriculture third roadmap which we have launched by the His Excellency President of India. By investing 1,54,000 crore rupees from the year 2017 to 2022, we intend to bring the Bihar on the map where every Indian gets at least one item from Bihar in their thali. That's what thali Bihar ka expansion. That's what we advocate for that. The agriculture roadmap aims at food security, and it also advocates of nutritional security, inclusive development, increasing farmers' income through sustainable production technology. The essence of agriculture roadmap lies in diversification of our existing food system. The agriculture roadmap envisages 53% increase in the rice production, 20% increase in the wheat production, 134% in the increase in maize production, that's our target, 681% increase in the pulses production, 260% increase in the algae production, 46% increase in the fruit production, 75% increase in vegetable production, 83% increase in the milk production, 392% increase in the egg production, and 24% increase in the meat production, and 58% increase in the fish production. That's our target which we intend to achieve by 22. The cropping system in Bihar is primarily dominated by cereals. More than 70% of the grass crop area is occupied by the rice and wheat. The pulses areas in production have remained largely stagnant. Therefore, a diversification of our existing cropping pattern is needed. Fruits and vegetables provide ample opportunity for diversification. The roadmap milestone are extremely challenging. Nonetheless, it clearly prioritizes the objective of agriculture development in the state. One copy of the agriculture roadmap, I have brought it, that is in English version. I will leave it to Dr. Gupta. And then if he intends, he can circulate to the audience. And we have also put on the website of the Bihar Government Agriculture Department. The agriculture roadmap has identified seed, organic manure and fertilizer, improved farm machines and the updated crop technology as critical intervention for productivity enhancement. Horticulture sector has duly been emphasized as sunrise sector, critical for income enhancement of farmers and also for nutritional security and population. Coming to the nutritional security, we have given a lot of emphasis for animal husbandry, dairy and fishery sector. The animal husbandry and beef field, that we cannot increase the income of the farmer unless we give emphasis for the animal husbandry and dairy sector. So a lot of emphasis has been given to this sector. And we are giving emphasis for the agriculture research, education, extension, so that we can increase the, we can diversify the area of the agriculture. We feel that agriculture can't be treated in isolation. We feel that there is need for integrated industry where all sectors of the agriculture and allied activities need to be educated, researched and trained in the same field. Therefore, we in Bihar, we as on day today, we have three agriculture and allied activities in our state, one in the central sector, two in the state sector, but we are advocating for integration. We are giving lot of emphasis for fisheries education. We have opened a new fisheries college. We have opened many agriculture colleges. And also we intend to open more university colleges in Bihar so that allied activities must be strengthened. Horticulture sector has duly been emphasized as sunrise sector critical for income enhancement of farmers and also for nutritional security of the population. The agriculture roadmap draws extensive plants and breed improvement of animals and to protect animals against diseases. Basic infrastructure of bulk storage of milk and its processing has also been emphasized. Improvement in supply of fish seed and feed will increase fish production. It is no less important that a production milestone can be achieved provided we can assure remunerative return to farmers. That's one of the areas of the concern. We in Bihar have repealed the APMC Act. Now, we have to study the effect of the repeal or what is the alternate model method of the marketing could be developed. So I will request the Professor Saiwal Gupta if you can take this study and if you can appropriately advise the Bihar government. So some method of the marketing system, whether that need to be introduced, because we are very concerned that APMC Act in the old form will never be brought back in Bihar. That state government will have that policy. But what is the alternate method available to us, that also we need to be advised. Few days back, my neighboring state agriculture production commissioner on the advice of the chief minister asked us what is the impact of the repeal of the APMC Act. Since we do not have the proper study done, therefore we could not apply appropriately to the UP government, but that need to be studied. And whether this alternate method in a simplified model could be experimented with, that we need to study. But we have to ensure remunerative returns to the farmer. A robust agriculture market system is needed. That we feel, if we intend to allocate that farmer's income has resulted on what parameter, what basis we are going to calculate the income to be doubled by 2022 or not, that we need to study. A three about marketing, we have in the meat sector, we have experimented a very stabilized form of the cooperative federation that we call the cooperative model of the milk sector that is working successfully. We intend to do same thing for the vegetable federation, three tier system, primary, intermediary and the apex vegetable federation that is part of the agriculture roadmap that we are trying to develop. And many of the countries in the Gulf have also shown their interest to come to Bihar to get the vegetable to be taken to their country. And that we cannot do unless we develop a marketing system for aggregation of the vegetable and processing and therefore transporting. That's what we are trying to experiment. As I mentioned earlier, a network of the cold chain and food processing industry will provide much needed source to the food diversification system in Bihar. The agriculture roadmap, as I mentioned earlier, is the integration of the activities of 12 departments of Bihar government. When we call 12 departments, basically core departments we consider the agriculture, environmental, fisheries, dairy, and cooperative to that extent. And there are some supporting departments, what we call is rural roads, the water sources, the minor or major. Land reforms essence to the agriculture production, and we intend to include the more forest coverage for the Bihar. We intend to make it from 15% coverage as I mentioned to 17% by year 2022. And we intend to make the environment clean, and this is our objective to achieve by 2022. Today's deliberation, which is a creation of so many experts, will provide further light on how to achieve the milestone set for agriculture roadmap. I look forward to the outcome of the deliberation and assure you that the suitable solution will be implemented in the interest of the farmers of the state. With this, I thank all the people, especially Professor Gupta, who gave me the opportunity to come here and share the view of the Bihar government. Thank you very much.